Hi everyone, welcome back to Science at Home, and for today we'll be exploring about the idea of the carbon compounds, or simply all about the organic compounds. But not necessarily all of the carbon compounds or those compounds made up of carbon are really organic. But first, let us try to explore what does the term organic mean. Now, when we talk about the term organic, we always think of the different compounds that were extracted from living things. But this idea was proven wrong when a German scientist named Friedrich Wöhler tried to synthesize urea, an organic compound, from ammonium cyanate. And from this idea, he was able to conclude that not all organic compounds were extracted from living things. So, the idea of the term organic is came from living things is proven as wrong. Now, from here, we'll be focusing on a specific branch of chemistry named organic chemistry. But what does the idea of organic chemistry focuses on? Now, when we talk about organic chemistry, this refers to the specific branch of chemistry that deals with the study of the different carbon compounds with an attached hydrogen atom on it. So, an example of an organic compound that we have right here is methane. So, it is made up of one atom of carbon together with four atoms of hydrogen bonded on it. Now, ideally, organic compounds has different set of properties. First of it is that most of the organic compounds are covalent in nature simply because that organic compounds are made up of nonmetals. Next is that they are tend to be insoluble in water simply because that most of the organic compounds are nonpolar in nature. And lastly, they are characterized with low melting and boiling points. Now, as you can see in this table, we can see the first 10 hydrocarbons based on its increasing number of carbon atoms. Now, if we will try to look on the molecular formula and the melting and boiling points, we can observe that as the number of carbon increases, the number of bonded hydrogen atom also increases, and also with regards to the melting and boiling point, it also increases as the number of carbon atom increases. But before we proceed in studying the different types of carbon compounds, let us first try to explore how do these organic compounds form, and this is possible through the process of hybridization. So this refers to the idea in which one or more orbitals within the atom tends to form or to combine together in order to form a new orbital. In the case of carbon, it has four valence electrons, which is distributed within the s and the p sublevels. So as illustrated, the carbon atom can undergo three types of hybridization, namely the sp3, the sp2, and the sp hybridization. Now, this is somehow connected to the idea of how the carbon atom form different bonds. When we talk about the hybridization of the carbon atom, it can form into three types of bonds. So first, let us go to the idea of the single bond. So all of the carbon atoms that tends to form single bond undergoes the sp3 hybridization, in which all of the three orbitals of the p sublevel tends to combine with the s sublevel. On the other hand, another type of the carbon hybridization is the formation of the double bonds. In the case of the sp2 hybridization, in which two orbitals of the p sublevel tends to combine with the s sublevel, so therefore forming double bonds. And lastly, we have the sp hybridization, in which it tends to form triple bonds, wherein only one orbital from the p sublevel tends to form with the s sublevel. Now, let us proceed on the different types of carbon compounds, starting with the hydrocarbons. So, as the name implies, hydrocarbons technically means that these are compounds in which it has carbon and hydrogen atoms bonded together. Hydrocarbons can be classified into two. First, we have the aliphatic or the straight chain hydrocarbons, and we have the aromatic hydrocarbons. Now, let us try to compare these two together. So, as you can see in this concept map, aliphatic hydrocarbons can be classified as either an alkane, a cycloalkane, an alkene, or an alkyne, depending on the number of bonds present in it. So let us start with the alkanes. So ideally, alkanes are also known as the paraffins, in which it has a general formula of CnH2n+2, in which the n represents to the number of the carbon atoms. So ideally, alkanes form single bond, and it is named using the suffix ane. In this illustration, we have here ethane. We have two carbon atoms with a single bond, so it is named as the ethane. So ideally, alkanes are used primarily as fuels. So the most basic form of the alkanes is the methane, in which it is made up of one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms. So methane is primarily the fuel that is extracted from fossil fuels. So another example is butane, in which it is made up of four atoms of carbon and 10 atoms of hydrogen, wherein butane is widely used as fuel for gas stoves. So next we have alkenes. So alkenes is also known as the olefins, in which it has a general formula of CnH2n, in which again the n signifies the number of carbon atoms. So ideally, alkenes possess double bonds, in which it is named using the suffix ene. So we have here ethene as an example. So in which it is made up of two carbon atoms and four hydrogen atoms. So ethene or ethylene is the known plant hormone that is the one responsible for the ripening of fruits. So alkynes has the general formula of CnHn, in which the N signifies the number of carbon atoms, wherein alkynes possess triple bonds, and it is named using the suffix "-ine". So our example right here is ethyne, in which it is made up of two carbon atoms and two hydrogen atoms. So as you can see in the illustration, there is a triple bond in between the carbon atoms. So ethyne or acetylene is commonly used as fuel for blowtorches. So those are the hydrocarbons that are under the aliphatic hydrocarbons. Now let us proceed to the another class of hydrocarbons, which are the aromatics. Now the term aromatics is somewhat associated to the benzene ring, which has a formula of C6H6, in which it is made up of 6 carbon atoms and 6 hydrogen atoms. So the term aromatic was coined from the term aroma, wherein all of the aromatic compounds are associated with a strong odor. So one characteristic of the benzene ring is that it has an alternating number of single bonds and double bonds within its carbon atoms. So ideally, the benzene ring is made up of 3 single bonds and 3 double bonds. Most of the aromatic compounds contains the benzene ring. Now let us proceed to the idea of the functional groups. But what does the term functional group mean? Now, when we talk about functional groups, this refers to the group of atoms connected to hydrocarbons that give special properties to the specific compounds. So let's say that we have the methane. Okay, but what will happen if we tend to attach different functional groups? So in this case, we have the first example. So as you can see, it is made up of one methyl group. So methyl was coined from the term methane. So it is made up of one carbon atom. And in this case, we have an OH attached on it. So in this case, the OH is the functional groups, which makes this compound as methanol. So later on, we'll try to explore what does these functional groups mean. Now, another example is that it is still made up of the methyl group, wherein it has one carbon atom, but this time it has an NH2 group or the nitrogen group. So this is now named as the methylamine. And lastly, we have here still the methyl group, okay, with one carbon atom, but this time it is made up of another carbon atom with a oxygen double bonded on it together with another OH. Now this time it is named as acetic acid. Methanol, methylamine, and acetic acid are different types of compounds, but it is made up of the same number of carbon atoms. But why is it so? It is because of the functional groups. Now let us try to explore the different functional groups. But again, we'll be focusing only with the most common functional groups. Let us first start with the alcohols. Now, alcohols is characterized by a hydroxyl group. Now, the hydroxyl group is represented through the OH, simply because that it is made up of the oxygen and hydrogen atoms. So ideally, alcohols are named with the suffix "-ol". So ethanol or the ethyl alcohol is made up of 2 carbon atoms together with the OH group. So ethanol, as we all know, is one of the important components that are found in alcoholic beverages such as wine. But let us try to explore other types of compounds with an alcohol. So first we have here ethylene glycol, wherein it is made up of 2 alcohol groups. So ethylene glycol is used primarily as antifreeze coolant in terms of automobile engines. Another example we have here is glycerol or glycerol, wherein it is made up of 3 alcohol groups. Now glycerol is also known as the glycerin, wherein it is widely used in cosmetic products. And lastly, we have the isopropanol, or also known as the isopropyl alcohol. So isopropyl alcohol, as we all know, is used primarily as a disinfectant. So next functional group that we have here is aldehyde. Now aldehyde is made up of a carbonyl group with a hydrogen. Now when we talk about the term carbonyl, it is a carbon atom that has an oxygen with a double bond on it. But in this case, aldehydes are made up of a carbonyl group with an additional hydrogen atom bonded on it. Now aldehydes are named using the suffix "-al", or somewhat aldehyde. So one of the most common aldehydes that is widely used in the industry is the formaldehyde. Formaldehyde is also known as formalin, wherein this is used in preserving tissue specimens. Aldehydes can also be found in different plant extracts, such as the following. So benzaldehyde has one aldehyde group, wherein benzaldehyde is also found in the oils of almonds. Next, we have cinnamaldehyde. It is also made up of one aldehyde group, and it is found on the oils of cinnamon. And we have citronellal. It also has one aldehyde group, wherein it is the one found most of the citrus fruits such as lemon and orange. Okay, third, we have ketone. So as you can see, ketones are only made up of a carbonyl group, and it is named using the suffix -one. So again, when we talk about carbonyl group, this refers to a carbon atom with an oxygen double bonded on it. One of the most common types of ketones is the acetone, wherein it is used as a cleaning agent in cosmetology. So acetone is made up of one carbonyl group. Take note as well that when we talk about ketones, this refers to a carbonyl group that is found between two different hydrocarbons. Next, we have carboxylic acids. Now, this time, when we talk about carboxylic acids, this contains the carboxylic group or the COOH. Now, when we talk about a carboxylic group, this also contains a carbonyl group. But this time, the carbonyl group contains an additional hydroxyl group on it. So, ideally, when we talk about a carboxylic group, it is made up of a carbon with a double bond oxygen on it together with an additional OH group. So, carboxylic acids is named using the suffix IC acid or the oic acid. So, one of the common carboxylic acids that are found is the acetic acid. Now, acetic acid contains one carboxylic group, wherein acetic acid is the known active ingredient in vinegars. So, other examples of common carboxylic acids are the following. So first, we have butyric acid, which has one carboxylic acid group. So the butyric acid causes the foul smell in human vomit. So next, we have the citric acid, wherein it is made up of three carboxylic acid groups. And it is the one found in different citrus fruits. And lastly, we have oleic acid, wherein it is also made up of one carboxylic acid group. And this is the fatty acid that is found on different types of nuts together with avocado and olive. Next, we have ethers. Now, when we talk about ethers, this refers to an oxygen atom that is found between two hydrocarbon groups. So ethers are named using the suffix oxy, in which it is associated with the oxygen atom. So an example that we have right here is diethyl ether, in which it is used before as an anesthetic. Okay, next we have esters. So esters are functional groups that are found between two hydrocarbons, wherein it is made up of a carbonyl group. So again, when we talk about carbonyl, this refers to a carbon with an oxygen double bonded on it. And in addition to this, carbonyl is another oxygen atom. So most of the carbon compounds that contains esters are used primarily as fruit flavorings and natural scents. So such as the following. So first we have here ethyl butanoate, which is the natural scent for pineapple. Next we have methyl salicylate, which is the natural scent for mints. And lastly we have isoamyl acetate, which is the natural scent for bananas. Now, let us go to the functional groups that contains nitrogen atoms, starting with the amines. Now, when we talk about amines, this contains the nitrogen group with an hydrogen bonded on it. Now, it is named using the suffix amine or in. Okay, some of the examples right here are the following. So, first, we have histamines. So, histamine is the compound that causes different allergic reactions. Okay, next, we have caffeine. So, caffeine, as we all know, is the compound found in coffee. And lastly, we have nicotine. So, nicotine is the one that is found on cigarettes. And lastly, we have amides. Now, when we talk about amides, these are also nitrogen groups, but this time, it is connected with a carbonyl. So, a common carbon compound that contains an amide is the acrylamide. Now, acrylamide, which contains the amide group, is the one found on different food products that undergoes high heat processes. So, such as this one, we have the toasted bread. So, that concludes our episode for today. This is Sir Dave saying, keep safe and always have fun learning science at home. Goodbye!